You should be ashamed of yourself going out of your way trying to make the Honorable Elijah Muhammad become secondary. Let me make this announcement to you today. I don't care who you mention, any combination of people, nobody that you know have come close to equaling the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Did you hear what I said? Nobody.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome to another show. I'm Kim Muhammad, your guest host for the next, 55 minutes or so. I want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to spend some time with us. Regardless to what platform you're on, I want you to take time, if you have not subscribed to us, to please subscribe and share the show. And tell others, you know, about the show and what we try to do here, and that is to bring information to you. We just came off the heels of Founders Day, and we still are really basking in the event. We do want to thank those people who came out and gave their money. I want to thank you, and on behalf of even the co-founders, say thank you. And those who did not attend but gave, we want to thank you. And if you didn't get a chance to come, 365 days a year we're doing this work, we welcome your donation. This is a 501c3 organization. It's dedicated to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You're going to find something here that you won't find anywhere else. So having said that, today is a very special day. Let me remind the callers, because I always forget. You can call us at 773-434-6625. But this is also a special day. This is the birth anniversary of Brother Munir Muhammad, and I have a few people here who are going to take time and tell us about Brother Munir. But when we talk about Brother Munir, we're also talking about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and this work that we've been involved in. It's been a great work. So I want to, as Brother Munir said, there's no combination of people that you can put in front of us that can or will ever exceed the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Jeez. And we will carry that on no matter what. And that's what's unique about what we do here. That's our niche market, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And so when you come here, you're not gonna get anything but the straight talk of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. But joining me today is Brother Earl Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, sister.
And Brother George Malachi, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
We don't see you as often, Brother George, but on camera, because you are busy working. But the beautiful thing about when we talk about Brother Munir, we have to talk about friendship. And we've been friends for a very long time. And our friendship has been centered around the work of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Brother Munir took us into a place that I don't think most people will ever understand. It wasn't just the physical work, being behind a camera or in the control room. He took us somewhere else. And I just would like for you all to give the audience, when we talk about friendship and talk about this teaching, what Brother Munir did for you and even this organization, this wonderful organization, the Coalition for the Remembrance of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Well, I wasn't expecting to be at this position where I am now, because when I came up, I wasn't interested in any of this type of teaching or whatever it was. I was a child that questioned a lot of things, and I didn't get sufficient answers to what I was questioning. So, you know, when I heard about, I think the first thing I heard about, what I saw was Farrakhan defending Jesse Jackson. And I said, I'd never seen, nothing like this. So, you know, he appeared at the final call building, and I went over there and listened to him a couple of times. And then one day at work, I used to work the midnight shift, I heard Munir on WVON saying that he has some tape of Malcolm X. So I said, well, if you have a tape of Malcolm X, I just bought the autobiography and I started studying this now. I read maybe about 7 pages. Then I came over to get some tapes of Malcolm, and the place was closed. Guy came about 8:30, 9 o'clock. And so I called back next day and they said, no, we're not open until 10. I think he said 10 or 9 or 10. So I came back the next day and I started talking to Brother Munir. And he told me about the messenger and said, this is Malcolm's teacher. So I said, that's who I need to know then, Malcolm's teacher. Mm. So then I keep going back and forth, coming back and forth to CROE, and Munir would take me and give me tapes and stuff. So I end up studying on my own. And I found out that reading Mystery of the Black Man, the first chapter, Who's This Mystery God and stuff, answered all of my questions nobody else could answer. Mm. So, Munir was a true friend to me. Mm. Made him sometimes argue sometimes, but you don't expect everything to be 100%. We go back and forth, mm-hmm. but it's really the truth, what the Mystery gave us, that really bond us together.
And, like I said, I sometimes would tell Brother Munir, people don't really believe you real. I said, because you are so honest, the integrity, the way that he knew how to always purge your conscience. It was always going deeper than the average person. And everybody got so-called friends, but you realize that many of those relationships are superficial. Brother Wasim on Founders Day, I keep telling you all, sometimes I know people think I'm crazy, but between him and Pastor Davis, they both was talking about Brother Munir in a spiritual way. He touched me in a place, and I knew in that moment you basically was taken to another place. And so that's the beauty of Brother Munir. But Brother Earl, we got a call, but I'm gonna let you finish your comment first before I take the caller, but I'm coming, caller.
Salaam alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Brother Munir, when I first came to CROE, he wasn't in. The first time I came there, I ran into Brother Khalif the first time, because mm-hmm. I had been hearing Brother Munir on the radio. So, I was curious about it. So, I used to pass right by the place, which was on Ashland, 91st mm-hmm. and Ashland. I used to pass by it all the time, but I didn't know exactly what it was. So I came by one day, and it was a young man standing outside. He was on post, and that got my attention. I came by, stopped, came by, and got a chance to meet Brother Khalif. He was the first person I met Brother Khalif, and they was doing something. Mm-hmm. And I was curious about it. I had heard Brother Munir on the radio talking. I wanted to know what they was talking about. Mm-hmm. Now, don't get me wrong, I had heard of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. It wasn't like I never heard of him, but I didn't have the nerve mm-hmm. to get involved into it like that. So, but when I came over there, it was like some place I had never been before. Mm-hmm. We had books, he had the things I had never seen before. So I was curious. So at the particular time, they needed some tables because they had just started out on 91st. They needed some tables, and I was able to get those tables for them. And the reason why I got it, because the people that I worked for, they was, we could just get tables because we used to use them for displays. Mm-hmm. So anyway, I got the tables, and he kind of gravitated to that, and our friendship began there. Mm-hmm. One of the greatest things that ever happened to me. You're talking about a friend. This guy is a friend. He's unique in his own way. You cannot forget Brother Munir. Mm-hmm. So I just want to wish him a happy birthday.
Yeah. Caller, They said we have a call on the line. Call it.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Brother Hamid Sharif from Maryland.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, alhamdulillah. You know, ironically, I was laying in bed this morning. I was thinking about Munir. Yeah. When he was a young lad, when we was in our growing up in Birmingham. And I had, not too long, came home from service from Germany, and I was quoting my wife at that time. Munir, he was in his early teens, and he and some of his friends, you know, was coming toward us, and Yaman and I, we was walking, and I heard Munir tell his friend, you know, to hold it down until he passed by us, you know. So I always remember the respect that he gave me as a young man, you know. And then when we came up to Chicago, you know, and we got together, and it was Munir that went to the Temple Ferris after he had heard about it. And he came back and he told me. And I asked him, when was the next meeting? He told me. And I went that Sunday. And when I walked in, you know, I saw heaven. So Munir and I, we go back a long, long ways, you know. So all praise is due to Allah. But, you know, like I said, I was just thinking this morning, just laying there, thinking about Munir and our life and our life as we had went through life together, and we, you know, did many things together, even after, you know, we came into the nation. So when I saw the title today, I had to call in. So always thinking about my brother, you know, and remembering him on the anniversary of his birth.
Okay. Brother Hamid, are those shows playing in Prince George?
Pardon?
Are the shows playing in Prince George?
Yes, yes, it is.
Okay. Well, we're trying to make sure they get there.
Yeah, every Tuesday.
That's great. That's good. And what time they play and what channel?
On our local community channel, our 76. Mm-hmm. Comcast. It's our 7 to 6 Tuesday at 7 o'clock.
All right, thank you so much.
CTV.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, sister. Thank you.
All right, I think we got another caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
It's Brother Naba Muhammad from the final call.
Uh-huh.
I saw the tribute to Brother Munir, and I had to really just call in and express my feelings and my thanks. And to really say that his work bears witness.
Yes.
To what he believed, the man that he believed in, and his commitment to continuing the mission of that man and serving our people.
That's right.
It's one thing to say that you love someone. Mm-hmm. It's another thing to stand up for a man when others are not standing.
That's right.
And when you see a man who has contributed so much, and you watch him being not only written out of history, but you watch his history being distorted in front of your very eyes, and you see those who benefited from him walking away from him, and they seem so powerful at the time.
Mm-hmm.
That's not an easy situation to step into.
That's right.
So when you step into that situation, it says something about the type of person that you are, the type of character that you have, and your ability to stand on what you believe and what you believe that Allah has shown you, regardless to whom or what.
Come on.
And I think for him to not only stand and to speak, but to begin at CAN TV, to take advantage of something that was there, to understand that the value of communications, to take advantage of something that was there to such a degree to master it, and then not only move out and master it, but to then have your own studio where mayors, congressmen, diplomats, all of them come to travel internationally. That's very, very powerful, and Brother Munir was always very encouraging of me. personally. When I learned of his loss, it really hurt me, and it's kind of unfortunate that I've heard Minister Farrakhan say that we really don't know a person until a period is put to their life. Mm-hmm. And then they can really be seen in the light of what they have done, because now they have finished writing their testimony.
That's right.
And so for me to be able to remember him, to be able to honor him, and to see his work still continuing, that says something about nation building. Mm-hmm. And I think that we have to understand that in building a nation is composed of different institutions. Mm-hmm. But they're all related to a single identity, if you will, a national identity, and then the individual identity. But I just wanted to offer my thoughts and my respect and my love and my tribute to my brother. And hopefully the story, his story, will continue to be told, because one of the things that I have come to believe more and more, there's an African proverb that says, they live so long as we repeat their name. So one of the names that I try to always repeat is Abdul Wali Muhammad, the late Final Call editor, who was such an influence in my life. So I would say, let us continue to tell the story of Munir Muhammad. Mm. Let us continue to recite his name. Let us continue to do his work so that he will truly live forever. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You know, that is so beautiful.
Yeah.
And I think that's why I don't want to get emotional. Why we do what we do.
Yeah.
Because he set the example. And not only that, his love for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, his love for God. And the idea that, you know, I think talking to you two, I do know that we saw the essence of the man.
Absolutely.
We saw beyond just the surface, and we saw the work that he was really involved
Absolutely.
In. And so for that, I will forever be grateful. But I think we got another caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Calling from Birmingham, Alabama, by my dear brother and beloved brother, Brother Munir Muhammad.
Yes, sir, Brother Clarence.
I just wanted to say a couple of things about him. First of all, what I love most about Brother Munir was his extreme level of passion and commitment to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the nation of Islam. I mean, most of us never get a chance to be around Minister Farrakhan, not in that intimate way. But Munir, the type of person that you don't be around people like that too often in your life
that have
that much passion the teachings and the mission of the Honorable Muhammad. And it was very infectious. And I say it's still infectious. You know, that it transmits to people that in his presence. And then he, like Nabi was saying about his commitment. This brother not only did bring people to the studio, he traveled around the world to document the impact of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And he loved his city, Birmingham/Brighton and Bessemer. He loved to come back home and share that message and share the teachings and encourage other people and just inspire people and touch so many people. And there's just so much that can be said about him. And then his love, that he wasn't afraid of a fight.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't afraid to stand up for the teaching. He wasn't afraid to call a spade a spade.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't afraid to correct you if you said something wrong and you got out of line about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's teaching. He's going to bring you right back
Absolutely.
In line. And we know, as a matter of fact, his work still continues on by the work that's at CROE and those of us that been impacted by him. You know, I think that everybody, when you be around Munir, you have a greater appreciation for Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because he's going to slap you around until you get it if you don't. And I think that that's the beauty of him. You see, you know, the work and those of us that's around, working around that, how he impacted us. And I used to think he was so mean. I said, oh, every time I talk to him, he mean. And he said, "Well, you don't call me no more." I stopped back calling him, you know, but he just had a great love for the teachings. And it just put that in all of us that was around. And even if you didn't want to become a Muslim, you began to have a greater love for Abdullah Muhammad after being in his presence.
Thank you so much, brother. I mean, you all got anything to say? I mean, is this not what we've been talking about?
Absolutely.
I mean, every time we have a conversation.
Absolutely.
You know, that's Brother Munir right. is always on our mind. Almost, like I said, it's not a day that go by that I don't think about him and the work and the lessons that I learned from him. You know, Brother Munir went around the world in 24 hours on that telephone, but every time you talk to him, he was always, not only for me in a spiritual mood, but he was always trying to teach. He was always giving you lessons. And like I said, I think Brother Muhammad hit it on the head when he said after the period. And that's why I can't say enough that we were so blessed to understand and see why he was still present, to be willing to work side by side with him. I mean, Brother George was on call 24 hours.
Yes.
And Brother George would still be here. He would be down at the studio. Sometimes I don't know how he did it. I would say, like, does he ever work, you know, ever sleep? Because, you know, he was on call, but no, when Brother Munir called, Brother George found a way to get over here to do what he could do.
Yeah.
So, Brother Earl, we was down there after work. Like I said, we left our jobs to go and assist because we saw something greater than ourselves. And so people try to dismiss the Nation of Islam. You're not going to destroy this. Like Brother Munir said, we're not going nowhere, and we're going to keep with the message so that we can, at least we're going to be a light in this dark world. It's my understanding we have another caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Hi,
Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum
salam. This is Sister Mina. I just want to call in say thank you, the members of CROE, and for honoring and keeping the voice of Brother Munir alive so that people can continue to remember him. Because, believe me, CROE and the honor of Elijah Muhammad was on his mind 24 hours a day. He would listen to both the television and the radio at the same time, as well as talking on the phone, making sure that he's reaching people all over the world to learn about the most honorable Muhammad. And if you know Brother Munir Muhammad, you know about the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And I would just like to also say thank you, Sister Kim, Brother George, Sister Diana, Brother Rahman, and all of the members of CROE who are still working day and night trying to make sure operation is still running, because Munir used to always tell me, Amina, I'm going to live forever. And believe me, Munir Muhammad will live forever because the Honorable Elijah Muhammad will live forever. Because as we see what's going on in the world today, and as we read the books that the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad left us to read, we are seeing the fall of America, and he has taught us everything that we need to do to survive. So I thank you. I thank the members of CROE. I thank the people who work in the studio for always time out of your business schedule to make sure that the desire and the will of Brother Munir will continue to live on through CROE, the Coalition for the Remembrance of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And thank you for celebrating his birthday on his birthday eve. His birthday will be tomorrow, and he is truly missed by not only his family, but I think the whole entire world.
Well, like a salam. The scripture said, burn it on the tabernacles of their heart. And I think Brother Munir did a good job with that. And like I said, to be able to see and recognize in real time and see a guy going through a metamorphosis when he would say, I've gone past belief.
Yeah.
I knew it. Yeah. I mean, because it wasn't just the words, it was his actions. And I mean, you know, if you live in your life every day and you see what's out here, you should be able to see something is going on
That's
different
right.
with this
yeah.
guy
yeah.
than the ordinary person, because people talk the talk, but they don't walk the walk. And yet he had so much opposition against him on so many fronts. But yet, one of the things, and I know we were always in class on a regular basis, and from time to time in conversations, when I would be concerned about some of the attacks or whatever and all that he had on him. But one thing that was always consistent, I prayed for this. Mm-hmm. He prayed to be able to defend the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, mm-hmm. which means that if you're going to do this work, you have to be willing to take any and everything that comes with it.
Yeah, that's right.
So, I mean, you got a chance to see this. I mean, George and Earl, y'all can tell me some of their stories. Because also people took him as like, well, you know, we're not going to invite him to these affairs. Well, you know, he's that Muslim. But you, do you really think that Muslims don't read? That Muslims are not up on things? And most of the stuff that these people are talking about, you ask them, what planet are they on?
Yeah, correct. Well, you know, I heard the Minister Farrakhan said before, when Aretha Franklin kissed his ring, he said he recognized that the messenger has made him something he could never made himself.
That's right.
Yeah. All right. And Munir discovered the same thing, mm-hmm. what the messenger did for him. So I've never seen Munir that's not reading. Mm-hmm. He got hungry mm-hmm. for knowledge.
Yes.
And
yes.
if we depart a lot of this stuff to our people and they pick up the messenger's books and start reading, mm-hmm. you see the hunger for knowledge will overcome them also the same way.
Mm-hmm.
And you see the behavior and stuff will change mm. and make them a better person.
Brother Munir was a great lover of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I remember us going to a farm in New Jersey. We went to see Brother Woodrow.
Mm-hmm.
Brother Woodrow had a farm, so we went to see his farm. But Brother Woodrow had a lot of information.
Mm-hmm.
We got tapes from Brother Woodrow. We did a lot of things. Brother Munir came back and, you know, exposed us to the tapes and everything. Mm-hmm. If anything was about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, he would go and travel. I traveled with him to go to Washington, where we met Brother, the brother that had the Honorable Elijah Muhammad live with while he was on the road.
Oh, I remember
Brother
that.
Benjamin and Sister
yeah,
Clara.
Yeah.
In Washington, wherever there was information, he traveled, and I was fortunate enough to be able to travel with him. I never seen a man work so hard before in my life.
Oh well, you know what the Quran tell you? I think one of the sections was in search of knowledge. He was always
right.
in search of knowledge.
Right.
And one of the things I realized is that every time he was talking to somebody on the set, he was always in search of knowledge.
Yeah.
But not only that, he took that knowledge and he could always be able to lobby for other people because they would give him inside information.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, having this platform is not something that people should take lightly. We are always doing our job by not only interviewing the person, we're trying to extract information so we can go and maybe talk to another person that can help whatever the situation is. We are part of the community.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, if we want to, you know, tear down the community, I mean, all I got to do is walk outside the door. So if you want me to just be a person that's going to be anti this, anti that, that's not going to solve our problem. You know, we in the middle of a political season. All you hear is negativity on the radio about the politicians,
mm-hmm.
okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a politician, have no desire to be a politician. But like most of us who work the job, you know, it's not always
right.
easy. But nonetheless, we put people in office, but we don't always hold those people accountable. You know, so we wait till election time and we want to dump on them and say what you didn't do, but, well, what did you do? You
yeah.
know, I mean, and so I just sort of, let's look at both sides. And even if they could they still may not have been able to do it because they're working in a system that has never been fair,
yeah,
and a system that never will be right. fair. So you also have to understand the restraints that they're working within, that at the end of the day, you know, you can say, I want something, but if you don't have the majority of votes to go with that, then you out here by yourself. Then what you want them to do? I mean, if they open their mouth and they speak on behalf and say, hey, this is a good person. Look, we bring people to the show. Most times they leave here, they don't even tell people that they've been on our show.
Yeah. Yes.
They don't even tell yeah. people they come into the show. So we are constantly given, but we don't always receive in the same manner. It should be a two-way relationship, but it's not. But they said we have to take a break, so we're going to take a break, and you know, we'll finish this conversation on the other side.
Important message from former Illinois Secretary of State Jesse White.
I love Chicago, and like you, I'm concerned about our city's future. That's why I'm supporting Paul Vallis for mayor. I have known Paul Vallis for 40 years, and I trust him. Paul has the know-how and experience to fix what's broken. He'll focus on crime and the safety of every neighborhood. Paul Vallis will be a mayor for all Chicagoans. Join me in supporting Paul Vallis for mayor.
You're the sweetest little granddaughter in the world. You're everything I hope for.
Think in terms of this is just the team that we have because this is what's most visible. But we have to discuss these issues. Mm-hmm. We have to find the people that are committed to do this work. You know, they just see the finished product. In the last few weeks, we've allowed other people to sit in these seats and give them an opportunity to see what it's like on camera. But they have yet to learn the preparations that you get to in order to do this. See, you still have people behind the scenes that's doing things for them, but they have done a good job. But, you know, a lot of people will say to me, well, Munir, you know, it's really time to turn over the reins, you know, to, you know, someone else. You know, I had this philosophical conversation with another guy, maybe 15, 20 years ago, who thought that I was selfish with my time, that I didn't spread the wealth. This is a work program. See, this is not just done when you come before the camera. You know, we do this 7 days a week. I was telling someone that when I'm riding my bicycle, I'm listening to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. That's work. I'm being prepared to do what I do. I study him. I pay attention to him. That's why I know what I know. That's why I'm committed. You understand, we don't just read the Holy Quran during the month of December. You understand, get up and pray, you know, in that month. It's a work program, and when people understand that, those are the people you see on the floor all the time. And so I just want to say that to the public, because it's not that I want to snap them up, but I know when they tell me that, then they don't understand the labor that we're involved in.
Assalamu alaikum, and we are back. Such a great clip from Brother Munir, but that's the way he actually functioned all the time. You know, he said to know him, you would have to know him in this work. Mm-hmm. And so if you were not engaged, you could never really see and understand some of the things that he was trying to convey to us sometimes, because, you know, we get caught up in our lives, mm-hmm. and, you know, it's, I want this, I want that, and we want it quickly, and not understanding that these things are a journey. It's my understanding we have another caller on the line. Caller, you are on the line.
Thank you very much for allowing me to call in today. I just want to call in and say, due to Brother Munir allowing me to appear on your show and give a message that some stuff that I was involved in an investigation, I have been most grateful and indebted to him all the time, because that young man called me up and said, you want to be on my show? And I said, yes, sir. I would like to come on your show and tell my story. And from the first time we met until today, I've had nothing but admiration, because he's not kidding. You have to put the work in. Yeah. And I can tell when I came to the studio that the work was there. You just can't come in and just sit there and just start saying anything. You have to have your program all together, because people over at CROE are together. And that's a labor. He taught me that, you know, when you want to do some work, you got to put work in order to get something out of it. And so I just want to call in today to say that I am totally grateful for the people at CROE, and especially Brother Munir, for putting his arms around me and my guys and allowing us the opportunity to come and tell our story.
Okay, TC, it was good to see you, but when are we going to see you again over here on the sofa?
Well, I mean, I'm coming. I've just been busy doing some stuff. Right? You know, Brother Mandine and Shaeed, they know that I'm always around, and I need to come over there. Don't get me wrong. And I'm coming over here in a few minutes, and I told the brother yesterday that I would need about 5 or 6 shows to convey what I came over there years ago to say. And so I appreciate the open invitation, and I'm going to take you up on that. Is that okay?
That's okay. You know we love you, Brother TC.
And it goes right back to you and my family at CROE.
All right. Thank you so much. See, that's the work of a Brother Munir Muhammad. Yeah.
That's right.
He touched the lives of so many people. And the beautiful thing about touching lives is that he was never compromised. He was always the genuine Brother Munir Muhammad, who just happened to be a lover of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And that didn't take a back seat. Like I said, he could talk about anything. And it is a tragedy that so many events took place in this town and he was not invited to. And if you could have heard him on a Wednesday, Friday, or Sunday, Munir could break this thing down and it would be so simple. Like I said, you know, he was always, I've never been a drinker, he said, no chaser. Well, he gave it to you straight. You know, never mixed words. And so here again, you know, I'm speaking as a female, but you all are, you're male. So tell me about your brother and the way that he came at you so straight. How did that affect you, or how did it help to improve your life, or you saw something in this that you could, it could benefit?
Well, like you said, Munir gave it to you straight. And I like a man who comes direct mm-hmm. and give it to you. But when you understand the messenger and stuff, you end up with a love for your people mm-hmm. and your brother. Mm-hmm. And that's what Munir, he loved his people. And that's why we open up to anybody who wants to learn.
That's right.
Even if you're persuaded on one side the other, just come like he told Tyrone Powers. Just do some investigation, study this guy, and bring back the information and let me know what you think. Mm-hmm. We don't force you into this stuff. We give you the information, it's up to you mm-hmm. to process it and come out with some critical thinking of what you think, mm-hmm. and not the whole time thinking.
Did you want to say something, Brother Earl?
Yes, I was just thinking Brother Munir was the type of person that when you're around him, you want to find something to do, because he's always busy.
Right.
His mind is always running. He's always doing something. So, you know, like it was an honor to be in his presence.
Yeah.
To travel with Brother Munir, it was one of the greatest things that could ever happen to you, a person.
And you know, for a female, you got a chance to see a man who could still be a man, yeah. a man for other men, and yet he could show sensitivity, yeah. you know, like men don't hurt. You know, Munir expressed his pain and his feeling, mm-hmm. and yet he could still be a strong man, but it doesn't mean men don't have feelings.
That's
and it doesn't
right.
mean that men may not shed a tear or two. Men are just like women. We all
Absolutely.
Are human and we all have feelings.
Absolutely.
I think we have another caller on the line. Caller, you're on the line.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum salam.
How you doing, brothers?
Walaikum salam.
It's great to see CROE members on the television showing that we can hold our own. We don't necessarily need gifts because we got a lot to say. And we just prefer to highlight other people. Mm-hmm. But we can really do this thing. And we got a lot to say. I would want to wish a birth anniversary to really the family of Munir Muhammad, posthumously, because, you know, he was really, you know, a family to all of us. This mm-hmm. man was more, I was too old to probably call him like a daddy. But I tell you one day, if I ever wanted a big brother that was stern and direct and truthful, I couldn't have got a better
That's
big
right.
brother than Munir Muhammad. I have had the great pleasure of riding the highways and byways, and I kind of jockeyed for that position so the farmers would be free to go to these different places. I didn't care to, but I just wanted to be in that number. So thank you, Munir Muhammad, as she said, Munir Muhammad's family, for allowing for sharing this wonderful brother with us. I still miss him. I feel some guilt and some because, you know, oftentimes, you know, I was on the outs, but I had thin skin and the man was solid, you know what I'm saying? So I miss him dearly. So thank you, brothers and sisters, for having this wonderful talk about our great brother, because he loved the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Yes,
he the Honorable Elijah Muhammad was like a spear in his hand. Mm-hmm. And when he threw it, he pierced your chest. So, you know, thank you for having the show. Thank you.
All right. I think we have another caller. Caller, you're on the line.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum salam.
How y'all doing today?
Doing well.
Shai Bush, I'm calling. I just wanted to let y'all know, me and Brother Munir, we are long, 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 long life friends. Mm-hmm. I remember the first time I met him. The first time I met him was when he come through the door of the Nation of Islam.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, me and him used to see each other every day. When he would be going to the store, maybe I'd be going to the store. We would stop and talk. And we said one thing, that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad is no longer with us. We got to do something to make people remember his name, because people was trying to put him, you know, trying to just make the Honorable Elijah Muhammad not even recognized by anybody. So we said we had to do something to make people remember the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and remember the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the reasons why we started CROE, the Coalition for the Remembrance of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because he loved the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I love the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And that's something that we just love, because we knew the Honorable Elijah Muhammad was the man of God, and he was the man that saved a lot of people's mm-hmm. lives. But when Munir really, 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 he loved him. And he loved him with every beat of his heart,
that's
I believe.
Right.
He
yeah. That's right.
That's right. With every beat of his heart. And a lot of times, most of the things he talked about was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
That's right.
That was just it. And so if you knew Brother Munir, you knew one man that you know. You might not know everybody, but you knew one man that loved the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. That's
You're
it,
right.
brothers and sisters.
All right.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum
salam.
You know, again, Brother Richard said something, you know, that was also profound, talking about how people stood up, you mm-hmm. know, when the messenger was here, and then all of a sudden they disappeared. And this is important, what we do, all of us who are in the Nation of Islam and know better, you know. And, you know, the messenger said there would be no more mosques or temples, but whatever, how are you going to have a belief and you are afraid to mention this great man's mm-hmm. name? I mean, you know, we just got off of Black History Month. You know, you don't even hear his name. You hear his students. Right. And even when they played Muhammad Ali on the radio station, that was a joke, you know, because you take away the seriousness of the man instead of acknowledging his strong belief in the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. So I believe we have another caller. Caller, you're on the air.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum salam.
How are you, sister?
Oh, salam.
And brothers.
Yeah. As-salamu alaykum.
You know, this solemn day, I just sat and listened to the... I'm just a witness bearer to everything I've heard. This ain't something that I heard about recently or read about. I know this man. I know what he's made of, and I know his dedication to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. In fact, we're so grateful that we had this association with him, because I think somebody said, one of the callers, about how he would, not it was Earl, mentioned how he would go and do anything to get anything, any letter, sentence, tape, or whatever there was about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And it just made tears come to my eyes when I saw him interviewing Sister Claire, the woman that he stayed with, her and her husband in D.C. back in there. I believe those people was about 90 years old when we met them. But that didn't matter. The experience that they had with the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the instructions and how they were delivered, you know, his mannerism. Sister Clara said something he taught her, how to make a cup of coffee.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, if you tell me that this brother was not genuine or did something as a hobby, you know, and I watched him, not some days, every day. He was either with me or talking to me about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And it was just absolutely appropriate that we would start a place like this, the Coalition for the Remembrance of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And he's right. He is synonymous with Muhammad. Every time I see someone who hasn't saw him in recent times, you know, they ask me about him, you know. And because nobody has a greater work ethic that I ever seen than my dear brother, Munir Muhammad. And I think Allah was very pleased with him, as we all are, and want to be inspired continuously to continue the work of making known what we have learned about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I thank you, and I thank the audience, the callers, the people who were just listening, didn't have anything that they wanted to convey across the radio, but just wanted to acknowledge it. Thank you.
Thank you.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
You know, the last two callers, of course, were the co-founders. You know, Brother Munir really was a, he couldn't help himself. And so he has this, for him to be so short, he has this giant personality that you really have to step back. But you also have to give credit to the co-founders, because the other thing is, so many times you can have organizations and there is fighting among the leadership.
Yeah.
And so it becomes a problem. But what we had an opportunity to witness were co-founders who had the same belief. There's no shakiness in any of them, okay? But you recognize the talents of each and every one.
That's right.
And that's what the messenger said. You know, you have to step back and be willing to submit. Whoever is the strongest or whatever, you know, he always talks about pooling your resources. Mm. But it doesn't mean we're all equal. The Quran talks about we're not all equal. But for them to be willing to work side by side, and they was by that man's side every step of the way. And any disputes, I keep saying, I'm not talking about what I know, I mean what I heard, mm-hmm. and you all know too, mm-hmm. firsthand, that any dispute, any debate, who solved it?
He did.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad solved it. You
That's
know,
right.
When they put the book on the table, what the messenger said,
That's right.
everybody retreated.
Correct.
And did what the messenger had instructed us to do. And so that's something that, you know, for those of us who witness that, that's what we take, even though that the Brother Munir is not here. This is, the blueprint has been laid down, and so we have to honor and respect our leaders, and we will continue to follow the program of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, but we should never, ever forget the sacrifice that they made.
That's right.
Because that's the we're talking about for God. See, we're not talking about to an individual.
Right.
That's we're
right.
talking about a person and persons who sacrifice for something greater than that, their individual self.
That's right.
They were here every week.
Yeah.
They were here on Wednesdays and Friday nights and Sundays. They traveled with him. I'm a witness bearer. Tell the truth. But they still doing it. And this is what we have to do. I mean, you have anything to say?
Well, you know, Munir was like the fire behind everything. And then everything he touched, you know what I mean, gave you a spark.
Yeah.
People don't recognize the amount of work that he has put into this.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we'll do sometimes 6 1-hour shows, mm-hmm. and we do it editing after that also.
Yeah.
And he was always there with all of this stuff.
Right.
And then sometimes you'd leave and go and do a radio show after that.
That's right.
Trying to get this message over to our people. Because he believed so much in the messenger that he couldn't give up seeing the condition of our people.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we continue right now, because we see the condition still.
And I think even like doing the shows, we interviewed a lot of people,
That's
but
right.
he also took a lot of time making sure that we talked about this. Because he didn't ever want it to be misunderstood where what his base was and what his belief was. But it meant he was a civilized human being who knew how to talk to anybody.
That's right.
I don't care, you know, people That's right. run around and they think they know our beliefs and what you don't know nothing about our beliefs.
That's right.
You see what I'm saying? Because we talk to anybody, I have respect for everybody, like I said, but we don't always get the same, it's not reciprocity, you know, for us. Like I said, when you look at the election, you know, Lori don't deserve all of the criticizing that they have leveled against her, but she gets it, but some of it she brought on herself, too.
That's right.
I mean,
absolutely.
Weeks before she was announcing that she was going to be running for mayor, she was sitting right here. She could have made the announcement right here, but she didn't.
Correct.
But when she made the announcement, we never saw her again.
Right.
Until, you know, the end.
Yeah.
This is not right,
That's
you know,
right.
because we haven't done anything. Lori has a relationship with us. She had been here before when she was in the procurement
That's
office.
Right.
That's when
Many
we first
times.
Came in contact with right. her. So, you know, it's really frustrating for us, especially those of us who have worked on the production team, and we've seen the slew of people, the thousands of people who have come through here, you know, and yet, you know, I mean, Brandon did come, but Paul Vallis came too, didn't he?
That's right. That's
and he
right.
said, and he said he'll be back. But not only that, Paul Vallis has a record, and that's not—I don't care who you vote for. That's not my concern. But Paul Vallis, when I went and looked at our records, he had been coming talking to Munir since 2000.
That's
you see
right.
what I'm saying? But it also speaks to our work, okay? But we got a caller on the line. Caller, you're on the line.
Yeah, this is Calvin Jordan. I just wanted to call in. I'm supervisor in Rich Township, but I just want to applaud late Mr. Muhammad for what he had done for President John Stroger.
Yes, sir.
He had given him a platform when others didn't.
That's right.
Even though he was the county board president. But he was one of the first, and he always welcomed him, and it meant a lot to him. And he considered him not only a friend, but a family member to him with the way he would do things. But I just wanted to echo and let others know how much it meant, and even other people as he talked, even as you got to Todd Stroger, and even as you got to Michelle Harris, and even with myself.
Mm-hmm.
So if we hadn't had those platforms, a lot of things we wouldn't have been able to be able to communicate, but I just wanted to pass that on.
And thank you so much, Kevin, but it also shows how valuable our platforms are, you know, especially our black platforms that sometimes we take for granted, because if you're not on 257 or Fox or WGN, we just dismiss it. But we have to be willing to speak on all of our platforms, and especially directly to our people.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your call, because we love Todd Stroger, we love John Stroger.
And we love all people.
Right. But we also recognize what John Stroger did for the county.
Yes, he did.
And that's what we don't have today is a lot of strong black politicians.
That's right.
I know we're running out of time, so okay, you all didn't think you was going to make it.
No, I didn't think that way.
Okay, we had a great time. So on behalf of the co-founders, Brother Khalif Muhammad, Brother Shaheed Muslim, on behalf of the CROE family, on behalf of Brother George, Brother Earl Rahman, and the entire production team, I want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule. Until next time, I pray that Allah bless each and every one of you with the light of understanding as I greet you in peace. Assalamu alaikum.